Hello. I want to discuss with you the problem of the Canada geese who were staying in the water, not moving relative to the land, not relative to my house. Yet, there was an enormous wind from right to left. And why could these geese stand still? Well, first of all, when I posted the problem, I implied, sort of misleading, that water was flowing from right to left. But that's not the case. It's not a river, it's a pond. And so if water waves travel on a pond from right to left, it doesn't mean that the water is flowing from right to left. It simply means that water waves are produced and those waves propagate over the surface. And if you want to watch my lectures 801, I probably discuss the speed with which they propagate. Put water in your bathtub and put a cork in that water and then produce waves in the bathtub. You will see that when the wave passes by that cork, the cork will simply go up and down. I may move a little bit back and forth, but it's not continuously moving in the direction that the waves come over the cork. The water is going up and down, and that pattern propagates. So my pond is, in a way, like your bathtub. So surely, the idea that the water would be running and that therefore the geese have to do something to overcome that, that's not true. The water is not running. But now comes another key issue. And that is, the wind will push on the Canada geese. We call that air drag. And as a result of that, they must move in that direction of the wind. Now, admittedly, there is an enormous amount of drag from the water. If the geese were moved in this direction, they have to overcome the resistance of the water because their body, part of their body, sticks in the water. And that's a substantial effect. Put your hand in the water and try to move your hand from right to left. That's not so easy. You have to overcome the drag force of the liquid, so to speak. Is that the reason why the geese don't move? Not really. I have here a fake duck. And I will show these fake ducks. I have several in my pond. All of them are anchored with a rope to the bottom of my pond. If I hadn't done that, they would gradually, maybe slowly, but they would gradually move in the direction of the wind, simply because of the air drag. But yes, indeed, if this part sticks in the water, that of course causes a strong resistance for the duck to go in this direction. But it will. It may go slowly, but it will. I will do a few experiments out at the pond, and I will then use this. And I will throw this balloon, which is air-filled, on the water. I can assure you that not only will it go up and down because of the waves, but obviously it will be blown in the direction of the wind. It's clear, right? No one is going to argue with that. I have another balloon, same size, But I attach to that balloon a weight. This is a piece of metal. And so when I throw this one in the water, this weight will go down and the balloon will now be farther into the water. It will not sink. But it will go much farther in the water than the first one. So now, if the wind wants to blow this balloon in the direction of the wind, the opposition of the liquid drag will be substantially larger because there is a larger portion of the balloon in the water. And I hope I will be able to demonstrate that. At least that's my objective, and I haven't tried it. It's not so easy to try this. I don't have many of those balloons. But that's what I think will happen. And if it doesn't happen, well, I will have to come up with some explanation why it didn't happen. I have here a balloon which is heavier than the other balloons, smaller in area. If I throw this on the water, it will probably also move in the direction of the wind, but certainly nowhere nearly as fast as this balloon would do. Well, the air drag force, by the way, is proportional to the speed of the air squared. Air drags are very complicated. I cover them in my 801 lectures. You may want to view those. Liquid drag and air drag are very interesting and very rather complicated physics issues. So, what I will also do, I will sacrifice one of my dogs. That means I will never see it again, probably. I will throw this one in the water, and there will be a substantial amount of liquid. It will probably go up to here in the water. So there is a substantial amount of volume in the water. And so when the wind starts to blow it and move it, the water will object to that. But ultimately, trust me, ultimately, it may go slowly, this one will end up all the way on the left side of my pond. And if it takes an hour, well, then I will videotape it again 1 hour later to show you that indeed it has moved. So, it means that the Canada geese must do something to compensate for the wind. But that something may not be very large, because the drag with the water helps them enormously from moving. And so, yes, I argue that they will use their legs, pedal just a teeny little bit, to compensate for the movement due to the wind. That's the best explanation that I can find. Feel free to disagree with me. And I have posted all solutions that you have posted. So we'll now go to my pond and we're going to take a look. I will show you the two ducks which are in the water, which are anchored to the bottom. And that's why they're always there. They've been there for years. And then I will throw the balloon in there, and then the balloon with the piece of metal, and I will sacrifice also this duck. All right then, see you at the pond. Okay, two more comments are certainly in order. First of all, I said this is a balloon. That is not true. It is a ball. So it has a much thicker skin, and therefore it's way heavier than if it were a balloon of this size. So it would be interesting to see. It will, therefore, the fraction of the volume that goes into the water will be, maybe the water will come up to here. But I can predict it will still blow with the wind, I think. Another issue is, I said, I will sacrifice that duck. Well, of course, since it is a pond, ultimately that duck will end up on the left side of my pond, in which case I can find it there. There's a slight catch. There is an opening at the dam. The opening is about this big. It's a huge tube. And the reason why that huge tube is through the dam, that after a major rainstorm, that the water will not go over the dam, but then the water can go through this tube. The tube is big enough that the duck could go through there. So chances are I will not lose the duck, but chances are I may. Certainly, if I left it alone for a day or two, it would probably be gone. Minor details for now. So ready? We're going to my pond. Yeah, let's go to the pond. Alright, so here you see the two ducks that are permanently there, year after year. They are allowed to go a little bit, because I made the connection with the bottom of the anchor long enough that they can move perhaps back and forth a few feet, but no more. They're anchored to the bottom. Let me now throw this one in the water. And let's follow it then. Moving in the wind, and these are still there. It's moving already, so I can catch it later when it reaches the end of my pond. It may get stuck there because there's some plants growing in the water. That's why it probably got stuck. Well, it's hardly any sense in throwing a balloon. Now it breaks loose. You see, it's still there, moving in the wind, no question. And to some degree, that's what the geese have to compensate for. But of course, the surface area of the geese and the part underwater is not identical to this duck. But it's moving, and the geese have to compensate for that. I can throw in this balloon with the weight on it. I don't know whether that will work. Yup, okay, there it goes. So there's the balloon in the water, if you can see it. Where is it? The sun is interfering with me. Oh, it's going to the ducks now, and it's moving, very clearly moving. You see it? So this is the balloon that has the weight on it, and it's stuck now because there are plants growing from the bottom up, and it's clear that the rope that was attached to it is stuck there. All right, I think I have one more ball to throw in, and I'll be going get that ball. Okay, so you see the balloon is indeed stuck. Oh, it broke loose. Now it's going to get stuck on the ropes that keep the ducks in place. Oh no. All right, so I think I made the point. You can see now that the balloon is moving and occasionally get stuck because of the plants. I have one ball here which was going to throw in the water, and there it goes. Bingo. Moving like hell. Wind is moving it
very fast. Water is not running, but the wind is pushing it. And as far as the duck that we threw in the water here, not attached to the pond, it's all the way there. There. Oh, those ducks in the end, by the way, that you see there, are also anchored. But this is the one that we threw in. There it is. And if it gets closer to the dam, I will be able to fish it out of the water. All right, so the conclusion is, without a doubt, going back home, without a doubt, the conclusion is that, yes, to a large degree, the geese were not moving because the water is not flowing itself, but the water is going to make the geese go up and down. However, they do have to compensate for the air drag with the wind. You see the duck? The two that you see in the back are anchored, but the one that is still moving to the left is the one that we just threw in. There it is. Oh yeah, I'm sure I will be able to catch it again. And then I will throw it in the water and anchor it. Yeah. Okay then. Have a nice day. Take care. Yesterday was Thanksgiving in the United States. I ate too much. All right. There's the pond. Sun is blinding us out. And there you see the pond. And here you see the house. Have a nice day, take care. And let's be friends, of course.